Welcome to a session on photoelectric effect. In this experiment, we are going to determine the Planck's constant and work function of the given photometal, as well as we will verify the photoelectric effect practically. Let me introduce the apparatus used in this experiment. This is the micrometer, which is used to measure the current. This is the ammeter positive terminal and this is the ammeter negative terminal. It will measure the current. This is power on and off to the kit. And this is the voltmeter. So voltmeter measures the voltage. So this is the voltmeter positive terminal and this is the voltmeter negative terminal A. So anywhere if you find red terminal, it is positive. If you find black terminal, it is the negative terminal. So this is zero adjustment knob. And this is the voltage control. So you can apply negative voltage with the help of this voltage control knob. And this is the photo cell. Students, inside you can see it consists of a photosensitive metal. When light shines on this photo metal, it ejects the electrons. The electrons, if they pass through the wire, it will give the current. For that purpose, we have two terminals. So this is positive terminal of the photocell and this is the negative terminal of the photocell. And we shine the light through this hole. Inside there is a photosensitive metal. And this is the source of the light. You can switch on so that it will give the photons. These photons are falling on the photosensitive metal and it will eject the electrons. Those electrons are redirected through ammeter so that it will give the current. Let me explain how to connect the circuit. So this is the circuit diagram corresponding to this experiment. So it consists of a voltmeter. This is the voltmeter positive terminal and this is the voltmeter negative terminal. And this is the photocell. This is the photocell positive terminal and this is the photocell negative terminal. And this is the microammeter, ammeter positive terminal and this is the ammeter negative terminal. This is a battery. So now let us see how to connect the circuit. So to connect the circuit, let us take patch cord or connecting wires. This is called as a patch cord or connecting wire. So let us start from photocell positive terminal. So photocell, from photocell positive, there is a line between photocell positive to microammeter positive terminal. This line is nothing but a wire. So take a wire and connect it from photocell positive terminal to ammeter positive terminal. So this is the photocell positive terminal. This is the photocell positive terminal and it should be connected to microammeter positive terminal. So this is the microammeter positive terminal. Microammeter negative terminal should be connected to voltmeter negative terminal. So where is microammeter negative terminal? This is the microammeter negative terminal. It should be connected to voltmeter negative terminal. So this is the voltmeter negative terminal. Next, voltmeter positive terminal should be connected to photocell negative terminal. So this is the voltmeter positive terminal. Voltmeter positive terminal is connected to cell negative terminal. This is the cell negative terminal. So what about this battery? This battery is already inbuilt. So don't worry about this. Now the circuit is completed. Then how to note down the readings and how to start the experiment. Students, before starting the experiment, let us switch on this kit. Yes. Here. Yes, without putting any filter, so this is the filter, this is green filter to get the green photons and this is the orange filter to get the orange photons and this is the blue filter to get the blue photons. So without putting any filter, now adjust like this. So first of all, we have to adjust this ammeter reading to zero. How to adjust it? By adjusting zero adjustment, by changing this zero adjustment knob, we have to adjust this ammeter reading to zero. Now it is minus 0.04 something. Yes, students, by adjusting this zero adjustment knob, I precisely got zero value in microammeter. And voltage control, this voltage knob should be at the minimum position. So this is the maximum. If you rotate it in clockwise direction, this is the maximum, and if you rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, this is the minimum position. You have to keep it in minimum position. Absolutely, this voltmeter has to read 0 volts, but due to some technical error, it is showing 0.010, approximately 0 volts. Okay, right. Then how to start the experiment? First, let me switch on the source. Students, I switched on the source. Now, photons are falling on the photosensitive metal. These photons are ejecting the electrons from the photosensitive atoms, photosensitive metal atoms. So the ejected electrons are called as photoelectrons, and this effect is called as a photoelectric effect. So how to confirm whether the electrons are emitting or not? Here you can see it displaying some current. Before that, the current is zero. It is giving 108.5 something microamperes of current. That means, so here, due to the shining of the light, the photons falling on the atoms of the photosensitive metal, so electrons inside the atoms are ejecting from that photons by absorbing that photons, and those electrons are flowing through this wire and it constitute a current. This current is called as a photo current, and this effect is called as a photoelectric effect. So here we verified photoelectric effect. Apart from this, in this experiment, what we have to do? So we have to find out Planck's constant, and we have to find out work function. Yeah, right. Now coming to the experiment, we have to find out the stopping potential. First, what is the stopping potential? Stopping potential is the reverse potential we applied to the anode in order to get zero current. Let me explain. First, for which color we have to apply? Green color. Okay, this is the frequency of the green color, 5.9 into 10 to the power of 15. So now let me introduce the green filter. Okay, now we have to calculate stopping potential. How to calculate the stopping potential? So here you see, here what is the voltmeter reading? Zero. Now I am applying voltage with respect to this voltage control knob. So at a particular voltage, this current becomes, photocurrent becomes zero. That particular voltage here is called as a stopping potential. So stopping potential is the reverse potential applied for the anode at which the current becomes zero. So now let me increase this voltage. So here I am increasing the voltage, you observe. Correspondingly, what happens? The current decreases. Don't concentrate on voltage, concentrate only on current. So at a particular voltage, the current becomes zero. That particular voltage is called as a stopping potential. Yes, we got absolutely zero current. At what voltage? 0.345 volts. So no doubt. So the stopping potential for green color is equal to 0.345 volts. Now, immediately you have to bring this voltage to zero. Now, replace this green filter with the next filter, orange filter. So I am introducing the orange filter. This is the current corresponding to the orange filter. Now let us evaluate stopping potential for this orange color. Simple, students, increase the reverse voltage. Here voltage is increasing, correspondingly current is decreasing. Don't concentrate on voltage, only concentrate on this current. So you have to increase the voltage knob till you have to get zero current. Yes, here we got zero current. At what voltage? 0.263 volts. So no problem. 0.263 volts is the stopping potential for orange color. Now let us replace orange filter with the blue filter. Before that, what you have to do? Make this voltage to zero. So now replace this orange filter with the blue filter. So I am introducing the blue filter. So now this is the current corresponding to the blue filter. When blue photons are falling on the metal surface, this amount of current we are getting. So now we have to evaluate what is the stopping potential for the blue color. So increase the reverse potential. At a particular reverse potential, this current becomes zero. That particular potential is called as stopping potential. So now carefully increase the voltage in reverse mode. Yes, here you observe, students, what is the current? Zero. At which voltage? 0.692 volts. So this is the stopping potential for blue color. Students, you can observe one fact here. The stopping potential depends upon the frequency. For blue color, highest stopping potential. For green color, little bit less stopping potential. For orange color, least stopping potential. So it depends upon what? So frequency of the blue color is very, very high, so that stopping potential is high. Next, green frequency is more compared to orange, so stopping potential is second highest, and orange is the least frequency, so that it is having less stopping potential. These facts you have to observe. Students, now let me explain how to calculate Planck's constant and work function. So this is the way how to note down the readings. Already we have taken readings previously. And now let me explain how to calculate Planck's constant and work function. So these are all the readings previously we did. Yes. Students, now let us see how to calculate the Planck's constant from this experiment. So Planck's constant is denoted with what? H. So the formula is E, charge of the electron, into V2 minus V1. What is V2? Stopping potential of the second color minus stopping potential of the first color, into lambda 1 into lambda 2. Wavelength of the first color and wavelength of the second color is lambda 2, divided by C, velocity of light, into lambda 1 minus lambda 2. What is lambda 1? Once again the same thing. First color wavelength minus the second color wavelength. Here you observe this tabular form. Here we have to calculate frequency. How to calculate frequency? You know the wavelengths of different lights. Of course we will give. So these are the wavelengths of the green color. Lambda 1 is the wavelength of the green color. Lambda 2 is the wavelength of the orange color. Lambda 3 is the wavelength of the blue color. So 5363 into 10 power minus 10 meter is the wavelength of the green color. So how to calculate frequency, students? So simple formula you have. C is equal to nu lambda. So from this, nu is equal to C by lambda, which is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by wavelength of the blue color is equal to 5363 into 10 power minus 10. So that you can get frequency of the blue color. In this way, you have to calculate frequency for green color, orange color and blue color. Okay, right. So now, let me explain how to calculate the Planck's constant. I already explained the formula. Just to substitute the values. Here E is charge of the electron, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. V2 minus V1. Here we have taken, this is one of the color, this is the another color. So 0.40 minus 0.36 is equal to 0.04. So this is the difference between these two values, into lambda 1 into lambda 2. So corresponding to this wavelength, what is the wavelength of this first color? Lambda 1, 5363 into 10 power minus 10. 5363 into 10 power minus 10. The second color what we have taken is blue. So for blue color it is 5265 into 10 power minus 10. So it is 5265 into 10 power minus 10. So these are the wavelengths, divided by C, velocity of light, 3 into 10 power 8 into lambda 1 minus lambda 2. Difference between these two wavelengths. Difference between 5363 minus 5265 into 10 power minus 10. This is obviously 98 into 10 power minus 10. So you can use calculator and you can calculate it. You would get Planck's constant value. So here we got 6.1 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. So this is the absolute value of what? Planck's constant. Now in this experiment you can also calculate work function. What is work function? Work function is the minimum amount of energy needed by a photon in order to get out the electron from the metal surface. This is the minimum energy. If photon does not have that much energy, it cannot eject the electron from the metal surface. So this is the work function. So what is the formula for work function? H nu, frequency, minus E, charge of the electron, into stopping potential. That's why we calculated the stopping potentials. So H, Planck's constant value, 6.1 into 10 power minus 34, into frequency. You can take any frequency. Here we taken the frequency of blue color. Okay, here we taken 5.69 into 10 power 14. This is the H nu value, minus E, charge of the electron, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 into Vs. What is the corresponding stopping potential, which means blue color stopping potential? Because you take in the frequency of blue color, that's why you have to take stopping potential of the blue color. It is 0.36. So it is 0.36. So calculate these values and you will get W naught value. So here we got 1.9 electron volts. What does it mean? It means that in order to eject an electron from the metal surface, you should have at least 1.9 electron volts. If photon having that much energy, it can able to liberate the electron from the metal surface. That is the meaning of W naught is equal to 1.9 electron volts. Similarly, you can calculate work function for orange color and green color also. Ideally, you have to get the same value, because work function depends upon the what material we are using. So you have to ideally get the same value for remaining colors also. So this is the final result. So we verified the photoelectric effect, and we determined the Planck's constant, and we determined the work function. Okay, so this is the experiment, students.